Hello. So, today's video is going to be on healing. And it's going to be two different types of healing and the differences between the two and the benefits and drawbacks of each type of healing. So, the two types of healing are yellow ray and green ray healing. So, yellow ray is when you heal from the will of your own self and through the direction of energy by force into another being. So it's basically like a lot of people who do Reiki healing are using yellow ray healing, and basically they are taking energy and then using their solar plexus to amplify that and then force it into the other person's system, and that energy is then accepted by the other person, but it has only like a lifespan to it, so it loses its potency after a while. So basically you'll go and then you'll get healed and then you'll feel better, and then 2 weeks later the same thing will come back and then you'll start feeling bad again, and then you'll have to go back and then be healed again. And it's basically like the pharmaceutical version of Reiki healing. And the green ray healing is kind of like the holistic version of Reiki healing. So what the green ray version is when you actually open the etheric chakras and then you allow yourself to be a vessel for spirit to move through. So the only way this can be done is if the heart chakra is open. And you can tell if your heart chakra is open, is the best way to tell if your heart chakra is open is to see if you have seen everybody as being one, and see if you can see yourself reflected in everything around you. That's basically the qualifier that the heart chakra has to be open for real. I mean, you can say that your heart chakra is open and that you felt love, but you may not know what you're talking about until you've experienced true, unconditional, like, cosmic love, which is just seeing all things as being a divine reflection of yourself and loving that, because that is you and it's them and it's everything, so it's unconditional. When I say that, I really do mean that. Like, it's, I don't know how else to put it. I guess. How else to put it? It is that. It is. It. Anyways, so healing with the heart chakra is basically becoming a vessel for spirit to move through. And the way that that heals is different, because when that healing goes through the other person, it not only heals them from their illnesses, but it changes their very DNA structure. It changes who they are. It wakes them up to spirit. It shows them a new perspective, a new direction of thought, or of spirit, really. And what I mean by that is that, like, it awakens something in them. This kind of inert drive to better the self and to realize Christ or God consciousness in themselves. It also is a different kind of energy. It's not like a burst of physical or mental energy. It's like a reinvigorated love and just acceptance of life. It's like a it's like removing a filter from somebody's vision, or giving the blind sight again, if you want to talk about like metaphorical kind of things. You know, it's like feeding somebody spirit instead of feeding somebody ego. Because you can pump somebody up a lot with their ego, and you can make them really, really excited, and you can really forcefully heal some things technically, but those things are only being pushed down and repressed for that person, and it's not really going to the root of the issue. And the root of the issue always ends up being a disconnection from the universe, God or source. It's a disconnection from the all, or the entirety of what everything is. And that is really what kind of causes people to change for real, is when they rediscover that connection that they have with everything, because it's really the only thing that makes it worth it in the end, because it's the end goal anyways. The solar plexus is powerful, and you can really develop a very powerful solar plexus, and you can convince people that you're God, and you can direct people and tell them what to do in order to awaken themselves to realize that they're a piece of God, but they'll never be as good as you are, because you are God. You're the divine source God person in human flesh, when in reality we all are the divine source God person in human flesh. Because we are integrally connected to everything in the world. Everything that you experience is just as much a part of you as you are. Like, think about it two-dimensionally if you have to. Pull yourself away from your three-dimensional seeing, and then just look, and then see everything as this flat plane. And then you see your arms, and you see the background, but there's no depth there. So there's no difference between the arm and the background, because they're all part of the same picture. That's a two-dimensional way of looking at it. If you look at it three-dimensionally, then you can realize that in this picture, there's another point of view that you can have that is not in the picture. So you can actually back yourself up to where you see yourself in the picture, and therefore you know that what you are is not that person walking around inside of the picture. What you are is this other thing that's seeing the entire picture. This is actually powerful. Like, this is really powerful, because this is how you really go through self-inquiry, and how you find yourself for real, is you have to back yourself away from who you thought you are and see that you are a part of something more and something bigger than what people have been convincing that you are. No matter who it is that's told you anything, there's no words that can describe how big you are. There's no words that can describe who you are, what you are, your connection with everything. Like, the beauty of it is, like, it almost brings me to tears just thinking about it, you know? Because it's so... You see a bird, and you see it flying in the sky, and you feel yourself in that bird, because you see how integrally connected we are together. And then through that, you feel the innocence and the beauty of that bird. And then you look around, and you see there's another one, and there's another one, and there's another one. And they're everywhere, because they're all these different flying, beautiful, free aspects of yourself that aren't bound to a metaphorical ground. Now, these are also technically not as advanced when it comes to evolution, but there's no difference in time either, because that's all something that we've made up as well. So the evolution of these animals is all happening at the same time, and they're just as integral with everything as we are. But yet at the same time, you are everything. So it's really interesting. But these are the kind of realizations that come to when you start trying to heal with the heart, or open your heart. You just start to see that opening the heart, or the gateway into another dimension, because it's a different way of seeing things. It's seeing things through the eyes of a loving kind of presence, because you can respect everything as much as you respect yourself. And if you have been kind of working with yourself, then you probably have learned to respect yourself a lot, because if you didn't have yourself, then you wouldn't experience anything. I feel like I'm rambling at this point, but I'm just gonna go back into the healing. So how to heal with your solar plexus. Basically, what you do is you focus your energy into your hands, and then you literally sit there and you project your energy through your hands into another person, and you basically just go up and down their body. And as you're projecting that energy, you imagine them being healed of whatever it is that they're saying that they need healed from. And you're imagining them kind of being in a different state of being. And then through this, you also imagine your hands becoming bright white and glowing this golden white color, and getting brighter and brighter and brighter. And then imagine that light penetrating the other person's body and kind of leaking and seeping in through the pores of every single pore, every single cell. It's basically white light is enveloping and becoming the cells inside of every single cell of this person's body is bursting with white light and golden light. So that's how you heal with the solar plexus. That golden light is the solar plexus healing energy. Healing with the heart, you don't do anything. Literally what you do is you open your etheric chakras, you open your channel, you open it all the way, and you feel the energy flow through you, and then you look at the other person and you feel yourself, and you feel because you're at this point, when your chakras are open like this, you're going to be healed. You're going to be whole and holy in yourself. When I say holy, I don't mean like a walking Buddha. What I mean is like you are complete and whole, and your body is in good functioning, healed condition, and it's working on at its optimal kind of state. You feel into yourself and you feel the healedness in yourself, and then you look at the other person and you see that other person as being a reflection of you, and you see that other person as being you, and then you feel the healedness in them, and then they feel the healedness that you feel in you, and then you connect on a heart-based level. And then this is if they accept the energy, then spirit works through you and through them, and it makes this kind of feedback loop, and then you both mutually get more healed as you sit in that loop. And then by the time it's over with, they are healed of whatever kind of mental and emotional kind of stuff they had going on. And a lot of times, if they're truly being kind of moved through spirit, the physical kind of things will go away as well. So that's kind of the basis of heart-based healing, but I can go deeper into it later as I practice it more and more with other people. I think this is good for now, and I hope you guys got something from this. Yep. I'll make another video today because I'm feeling pretty good. So have a great day. Bye-bye.